Hey guys, welcome to Nerdarchy for Nerds by Nerds. I'm Ted, hanging out with
Dave.
And today we have a GM911 from Demon 87, or Daemon 87. And he has a GM911 where the players have left behind an artifact in his campaign arc.
Do you have a problem in your game and only Nerdarchy can solve it? Submit your GM911 to nerdarchy@gmail.com or over on the forums where we have a special section for that at nerdarchy.com.
So he's got six players, two veterans and four noobs. They went into a dungeon investigating this foul necrotic taint or whatever have you, and they encountered a book that was a culmination of many tomes and knowledge. And the players interpreted it as evil, so they left it behind. And he felt that it was important to his story, and they said, we can't destroy it, we're just gonna leave it here. And now he feels he's gotta scrap a lot of his campaign because the players did not take it with them.
So, first of all, Demon 87. One of the important things we need to learn as DMs is never linchpin anything on a specific action you anticipate the players will or will not take, because, or a die roll for that matter, because ultimately it will never happen. Now, that being said, why not reintroduce the book somewhere else later in the campaign?
Absolutely.
That's you could totally sidetrack this for, so you have this overarching theme. Well, one adventure puts it back on track with someone else using the book, and then it reappears again, and literally if they keep leaving it, you could literally have it keep re-showing up. it's like the clap that won't go away.
There really is no shortage of evil wizards out there who want power. So if the book is an artifact, if it's so powerful, it will engineer things in such a way to get into the hands of somebody who wants it. You've seen Lord of the Rings. You see how machinations happen.
Right, and it could even be that or even if the book doesn't have power over it, just if someone does happen to find it afterwards, it gets reintroduced into the world, and now, once it's reintroduced, the world at large knows it exists.
Right.
Because the player is left with knowledge that it existed, because some evil wizard came with knowledge that it existed. This is actually really easy, especially long protracted campaign. So you may have to sidetrack for an adventure or two or three or whatever it takes, but you can definitely get back on track with this one without even railroading, to be honest.
Right.
This isn't even a hard one. There's some cases where there is no easy path, but this one is, you neglected that problem, guess what? It's going to show up again.
Right. So the players were hired to go investigate this area. They go to the area, they clear out the dungeon, they leave loot behind, they left the book behind, they come back and they report. Well, I hate to say it, but politics are not all clean whistles, so someone in that inner circle is going to find out about it and be like, there's this powerful thing that got left back there. Maybe I should go investigate this or get somebody else to investigate it for me. And
or you could even do they report back and they're like, what do you mean you left the evil book where anybody can find it now? Go get it. What are you thinking? So they go back to get it and it's gone.
Right.
Maybe there's some clues or something like that, or it's just going to show up later and there's not much they can do about it. So there's you have numerous options here. It could even be, even if the meeting happened and they went and talked to whoever they had to, and then someone else could approach them later and go, what do you mean you left that book? After they found out. Don't you know what that is? That's a Necronomicon. You can't possibly just leave that there, or whatever. Or like Ted said, someone else, a shady advisor or somebody, goes and gets it for themselves.
Things will happen. Either the players can go back and get the book, or someone else is going to get it, and you can reintroduce that in a couple of sessions by, oh my god, this nothing of a wizard all of a sudden is doing all of these powerful spells. How did this happen?
I just want to thank Demon 87 for this is a lob. This is a softball. Like, you know, it's not, but, you know, my players are being a dick, or I have a player who's a dick and another one's an asshole. Like, those ones are really hard because, you know, they're all, like, out of game problems. Like, they're the ones that are tough and they're going to strain friendships and
not that we
and
have
your gaming group. But this one, this is a godsend. This is easy.
I don't have a problem answering, you know, hard or easy GM 911s, but yes, this one really is okay. They didn't do what you wanted this time. This goes back to the...
There's a consequence for that.
Yes, this goes back to that consequences video that we did. If the players don't do what you want, that's okay. It's not a problem. You have to figure out, okay, well, what do I do next? And, okay, well, if they didn't do this thing that's helping evil, great. Evil didn't stop. It's still going to keep going. Just because you thwarted one wizard, the source of his power is still there. Some other wizard's going to get it.
And not only that, too. Like it's an opportunity to teach your players as well, because they tried one thing to destroy the evil book, and it didn't work, and they quit. We tried.
I had this.
I hit the book with a hammer, and it didn't. It wasn't destroyed. What could possibly... I don't get it. I don't know. So if you're like, oh, well, and it teaches several things. One, you know, they had a problem and they couldn't solve it right away, so they kind of ignored it. Well, then now the problem can come back and bite them on the ass later.
But the important thing is it teaches them about the living world. It teaches them that the world that they're playing in is not 100% around them, that things happen outside of their circle, and their actions cause consequences.
Exactly. And that was the next lesson I wanted to pontificate upon, which Ted totally covered it. this is an easy one. This is not going to derail your campaign, your major story arc. And even better is you can do this without being railroady or trying to cram your story down the player's throats. Like, this is very organic happen.
I would totally be like, all right, you guys finish this. Figure out what they want to do next. Literally ask that question. All right, guys, where do you want to go? And meanwhile, the machinations are turning in the background. The book is getting...
This is actually... I think this is actually a blessing in disguise. Like, this is actually a more fun way for that book to get used later in your campaign. Indeed. Is for it to come back up, you know, organically and naturally as another storyline that's going to sink back into what you're doing. It ties into something they've already done. And they're going to be like when they have to confront the next mad necromancer who's, like, wielding the book, they're like, oh my God, he's got the book! How could we be so stupid? We just left it there for him to take, and now we got to fight uber zombies. Uber Nazi zombies.
Yeah, because, I mean, they're going to gain levels, so therefore whatever they fight next, going to be more powerful. So if you have any suggestions of things that Dave and I might have missed for Demon 87, put it down in the comments below. While you're at it, like, share, even subscribe.
You can enter a pact with Nerdarchy over on Patreon.
So until next time, stay nerdy.